In New York, I found myself in the center of the world. It is a vibrant city full of life and fun. We stayed in a hotel near Times Square and started our visit directly on boat trip around the island of Manhattan.
In history, look on your right side on top of the cliffs. I don't know if you can see this, but try. The American flag flies in a little park over there, and that's Marcus Fowler Alexander Hamilton.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it.
We embarked on the west side of Highland. A little further, we could see the Empire State Building.
Are longing to stray right through the very heart of it, New York.
Here, we can already see the construction of the new tower, the Freedom Tower, whose complexion is scheduled for 2013. With 1,776 feet, the symbolic number of the year of US independence. It will be the tallest tower in the US and the world's third largest. Here the Statue of Liberty, which was offered by France during the centennial of the signing of the US Declaration of Independence in 1886. We entered the east side of the island, where we can see the Brooklyn Bridge. In the penthouse of this building live Frank Sinatra.
Are melting away.
Right towards the Bronx and Harlem to the left. We return the west side of the island, and this is the longest bridge over the Hudson River and the main traffic inbound and outbound. There is the northern part, and we turn to the starting point. Here is the ground zero, where the Twin Towers fell. We now visit Empire State Building and saw one of the best views in the world. Able to leave anyone breathless. It has 102 floors and was built in 1931.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was raised. Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain.
Let's enter into another bridge to frame a better view. At right, the Soho area, and now Chinatown below. There's the charismatic Brooklyn Bridge. Before the end of our first day, we still had time to see the inside of Central Station. Second day morning, we were in the area of Broadway. We walked a bit to the 5th Avenue. We saw the St. Patrick's Cathedral and Rockefeller Center here. Here, at the 6th Avenue, we can see the buildings, where are the main financial rating agencies in the world. More than in Wall Street, this is where are now the commands of the financial world. We went to the American Museum of Natural History. Here's Harlem neighborhood in the north of the island, where there are many churches that triggered the gospel music. We are already close to the Central Park. With the main museum, so we stop at the Metropolitan Museum, where a group of street singing a cappella song. We entered the Central Park always with a lot of fun and excitement. Here families stroll enjoying this magnificent garden. At the exit of the park, we found a group of hip-hop that attracted attention. Nightfall follows the fun in Times Square. We are in full Broadway and we can now watch a presentation of one of the performances. We still had time to climb to the top of the Rockefeller to see the night view. And so ends our visit to New York. I feel sorry to leave this fantastic city that never sleeps, and I'll never forget. It will always stay in my mind.